In this video, we examine the concept of reduced mass, which helps us to describe vibrations in a diatomic molecule. Take two masses, M1 and M2, connected by a spring. These masses are at positions x1 and x2, and let the equilibrium distance be L0. The displacement from equilibrium, x, equals x2 minus x1, which is the full length of the spring, minus L0. If we stretch the spring, there will be a restoring force that pulls the spring back into its equilibrium. Let's combine Newton's second law and Hooke's law and write down the equations of motion for the two masses. For mass 1, m1 times d squared x1 dt squared equals plus kx. The plus sign means that after extension, the spring pulls the mass to the right. For mass 2, we get m2 d squared x2 dt squared equals negative kx. The negative sign means that after extension, the spring pulls the mass back to the left. We are not interested in a motion of both masses and spring together. We only want to understand the internal motion of the system, that is, how the spring vibrates. For this, we need to find an equation for how the displacement x changes over time. For this, let's multiply each equation by the other mass and then subtract the first equation from the second equation. We get m1 m2 d squared x2 minus x1 dt squared equals minus m1 kx, that's from the second equation, minus m2 kx, that is from the first equation. We can factor k and x out, and we get m1 plus m2 as an additional factor on the right-hand side. On the left-hand side, x2 minus x1 can be replaced by the full expression with including L0, that is the displacement, without changing the second derivative. Let's also divide now by m1 plus m2. So we get m1 m2 divided by m1 plus m2 d squared x dt squared equals minus kx. Let's abbreviate this prefactor here, and let's call it mu. Another way to write this is 1 over mu equals 1 over m1 plus 1 over m2. This prefactor mu is called the reduced mass. With this, we finally get the equation of motion that looks like mu d squared x dt squared equals minus kx. If we compare this equation to the equation of motion of a single mass on a spring, it's essentially identical. The only difference is that the mass is replaced by the reduced mass. For this system here, we can write down the solution, and the solution will contain the oscillator frequency, which will be omega equals the square root over k divided by mu. Again, the oscillator frequency is identical in expression to the spring with a single mass, except that m, the mass, is replaced by the reduced mass, mu. Let's look at a few examples for the reduced mass. Take m1 equals 10 in some units and m2 equals 10 in some units. If the two masses are equal, we'll find that mu is half of each of the mass. In this case, mu equals 5. If one mass is smaller than the other mass, m1 is 10 and m2 is, let's say, 4, mu gets smaller, 2.8 in this case. Note that it is smaller than the smaller of the two masses. As the disparity between the two masses gets larger, so if one is much smaller than the other, mu slowly approaches the lower mass. 0.9 is very close to 1. So in general, the reduced mass is always smaller than the smaller of the two masses. In summary, the reduced mass allows us to treat a two-body vibrational problem as a simple one-body problem.